Good morning all of you. In the previous class we have discussed the chapter derivative and we are solving some questions based on derivative of the NCERT book. So let's start some other questions of your book. One by one we will see. Question number 6. Find the derivative of x to the power n a x to the power n minus 1 plus a square x to the power n minus 2 plus dot 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 plus a to the power n minus 1 x plus a to the power n for some fixed real number. Okay, so our function fx is x to the power n plus a x to the power n minus 1 plus a square x to the power n minus 2 plus dot 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 a to the power n minus 1 x plus a to the power n. We have to given this function and we have to find the derivative of this function. Okay, so let's start. The derivative of this function will be, because here a square dot dot a to the power n minus 1 a to the power n is constant, so, and you know the derivative of the constant is what, 0. So we will write differentiation of a to the power n is 0. So differentiation of fx is equal to differentiation of x to the power n a differentiation of x to the power n minus 1 plus a square differentiation of x to the power n minus 2 plus dot 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 a to the power n minus 1 differentiation of x, and this is constant, so differentiation of a to the power n, it will be 0. So we write the differentiation of x to the power n is what, n x to the power n minus 1, and a is constant, and so it will be outside, and the differentiation of x to the power n minus 1 will be n minus 1 x to the power n minus 2 plus a square and n minus 2 x to the power n minus 3 plus dot 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 a to the power n minus 1 into 1 plus this is 0. The last term will be 0 because the last term is a to the power n, which is constant, so our differentiation will be n x to the power n minus 1 plus a n minus 1 x to the power n minus 2 plus a square n minus 2 x to the power n minus 3 plus dot 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 a to the power n minus 1. This will be our answer. Okay, no doubt. So we will see the next question. Our next question is, for some constant a and b, find the derivation of first question number 7, first part. Fx is equal to x minus a, x minus b. Okay, we have to find the derivative of this function. So here are two functions where a and b are constant and we have to find the derivative of this function. So what we will do, b differentiation of fx is equal to differentiation of x minus a, x minus b. Okay, so this is our u, this is our v. Either we can consider it first function, second function, and we apply the product rule. Product rule is what? First function differentiation of second function plus second function differentiation of first function. So we apply here. So we write differentiation of first function, first function differentiation of second function plus second function differentiation of first function. Okay, so this is x minus a. There are two terms, first x and second b. So when we differentiate both term, we write differentiation of x minus differentiation of b plus x minus b differentiation of x minus differentiation of a. Now x minus a, differentiation of 1 and this is 0, plus x minus b, this is 1 and this is 0, because this is constant, so it will be 0. Now we write x minus a plus x minus b and we get 2x minus a minus b, so it will be our solution. Okay, now we will see the next question. What we have done in this question, there are two functions, first is this and second is this. So we apply product rule of differentiation, first function differentiation of second function plus second function differentiation of first function. After applying, we take there are two terms, so the differentiation will be with both terms. So we write differentiation of x minus differentiation of b, and again differentiation of x, differentiation of a, and you know it is constant term and the differentiation of constant term is 0. So we write here 0 and here 0 also. So x minus a and x minus b, so we write 2x minus a minus b. Okay, I hope you understand. So we will see the next question. Second part is fx is equal to ax square plus b whole square. We have to find the differentiation of this function. So what we will do, first we will expand it. This is a plus b whole square. We write a square plus b square plus 2ab. Okay, so this is a square b square plus 2ab. Now this is our fx and we have to find the differentiation of this function in which a, b and 2, this is what? This is constant. This will treat as constant. Now differentiate it. So differentiation of fx is equal to a square differentiation of x to the power 4 differentiation of b square differentiation of 2abx square. So when we differentiate it, we get a square and this is x to the power n. So we write this n x to the power n minus 1, so it will be 4x cube. So we write 4x cube plus this is constant, so we write 0. And 2ab is constant and in x square, so we write the differentiation of this is 2x. Now we get 4a square x cube plus 4ab x, so it will be our differentiation. Okay, now we will see the next question. Given x minus a by x minus b. This is the form of u by v. So we apply here quotient rule, and you know this is our numerator and this is denominator, and the differentiation of n by b is what? F dash x. F dash x, x means first time, yeah, one time differentiation. So d differentiation of n minus n differentiation of d divided by d square. This is the formula of quotient rule. D differentiation of n minus n differentiation of d upon d square. Now solve it. We get x minus b, and here is x. The differentiation of x is 1 and the differentiation of a is 0. So we write 1 minus 0 and x minus a. The differentiation of x is 1 and the differentiation of b is 0. So we write 1 minus 0 divided by x minus b whole square. Okay, this implies x minus b in the numerator here and minus x plus a upon x minus b whole square. Now here x and x will cancel. We get a minus b by x minus b whole square. This is the differentiation of x minus a by x minus b. Okay, so now here what we have done, we have applied the quotient rule, and the quotient rule is that the differentiation of n by b is d differentiation of n minus n differentiation of b upon b square. So here is first function x minus b. The differentiation of x is 1 minus 0 minus x minus a. Differentiation of 1 x is 1 and constant term is 0. So we write x minus b 1 minus 0 x minus a 1 minus 0 x minus b whole square. X and x will reduce, minus b plus a. So here we get a minus b by x minus b whole square. It will be the differentiation of this function. Okay, now we will see the next question. Our next question is, our function is x to the power n minus a to the power n divided by x minus a. Okay, so we have to find the differentiation of this function. So we are saying that here this is again the form of u by v, and it is n. This is numerator and this is d. This is denominator. So we apply, what we apply? We apply the quotient rule, and you know the quotient rule is d differentiation of n minus n differentiation of d by d ka whole square. So we write f dash x is equal to x minus a differentiation of x to the power n minus a to the power n minus n differentiation of d by d whole square. Okay, now what we will do, we will apply. Now we will differentiate it. We get x minus a, and x minus n is the differentiation of x minus n is n x to the power n minus 1. So we write n x to the power n minus 1 minus differentiation of a to the power n, which is 0 because this is constant, so it will be 0, minus x to the power n minus a to the power n the differentiation of x is 1 and the differentiation of a is 0, and divided by x minus a whole square, this implies we get x minus a, and this is n x to the power n minus 1, this is 0 and minus, so here we get x to the power n, this minus and minus will be plus, a to the power n divided by x minus a whole square. Now this is f dash x. Okay, now we multiply it and solve further, we get n x to the power, here x to the power 1 and here x to the power n minus 1. So the base are same, so we write x to the power n minus 1 plus 1. So here we get n x to the power n minus a n x to the power n minus 1 minus x to the power n plus a to the power n divided by x minus a whole square. Now we will further write it. Now further we write this, but we are taking common from here and here, so what we get, we write what, taking x to the power n outside, we get n minus 1 and minus a n x to the power n minus 1 plus a to the power n divided by x minus a to the power 2, and this will be your answer. In this way we can solve the differentiation of this function applying the quotient rule. Okay, what we have done, we have applied d n difference n divided by d, so d differentiation of n minus n differentiation of d divided by d whole square, and we know the differentiation of x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1, and differentiation of a to the power n is 0 minus the differentiation of x is 1 and this will be 0, and divided by x minus a whole square. So apply, multiply this to this term, we get x minus a and x to the power n minus 1 and x to the power n minus a to the power n. Here what will be, the sign will be changed, here we write a to the power n with positive sign, and here x minus a whole square. Now multiply it, n x to the power n minus n a to the power n x to the power n minus 1 minus x to the power n plus a to the power n divided by x minus a whole square. Now here x to the power n is here and n is here, so we take common, we write n minus 1 and this is an x to the power n minus 1 plus a to the power n divided by x minus a whole square, so it will be our answer. Now we will see the next question. Our next question is question number 8. Second part is fx is equal to 5x square plus 3x minus 1, 5x square plus 3x minus 1 multiplied by x minus 1 Now we have to differentiate this function. Okay, so there are two functions, first and second. So we apply what? The product rule. And product rule is f dash x is equal to first function differentiation of second function plus second function differentiation of first function. Okay, now we differentiate it. What we get? 5x square plus 3x minus 1. Differentiation of x is 1. Differentiation of 1 is 0 because 1 is constant. X minus 1. Differentiation of, now differentiation of 5x square. So we write 5 to the 10x plus 3 and minus 0 because the differentiation of constant term will be 0. Now we get 5x square plus 3x minus 1 plus x minus 1 and in second bracket 10x plus 3. Now we write it 5x square plus 3x minus 1 plus, multiply this, we write 10x square plus 3x minus 10x minus 3. Now after solving we get 5x square, 10x square, 15x square, 3x and 3x, 6x minus 10x minus 4x minus 1 minus 3 minus 4. So the differentiation of this function will be this. Okay, now next question. Fourth part is fx is equal to x to the power 5 under bracket 3 minus 6 x to the power minus 9 minus 9. Okay, we have to find the differentiation of this function. So what we will do, first we multiply this, we get 3 x to the power 5 minus 6 x to the power minus 9 plus 5, it will be minus 4. So fx is this. Now we have to find the differentiation of this function, which is very simple. So we apply the differentiation of x is 3 differentiation of x to the power 5 minus 6 differentiation of x to the power minus 4. So 3 into 5 x to the power 4 minus 6 into, it will be what? Minus 4 x to the power minus 4 minus 1. So we get 15 x to the power 4 minus minus plus 6 4s are 24 x to the power minus 5. Okay. Now we write this 15 x to the power 4 plus 24 by x to the power 5. Now take LCM, we get x to the power 5 15 x to the power plus 24, it will be our answer. Now we will see the next question. Our next question is, question number 6, fx is equal to 2yx plus 1 minus x square y 3x minus 1. Now we have to given this function and we have to find the differentiation of this function. So let's start. F dash x is equal to what? We write 2. First we write 2x plus 1 to the power minus 1. And here it will be x square by 3x minus 1. Now differentiation of f dash x is 2. X to the power minus 1, so minus 1, x plus 1 to the power minus 2, and differentiation of x plus 1 is 1 and minus. Here we apply the quotient rule, which is d differentiation of n minus n differentiation of d divided by d whole square. Now f dash x is equal to minus 2 divided by x plus 1 whole square. Okay. Now minus here 3x minus 1 differentiation of x to the power n is what? N x to the power n minus 1 and minus x square. Here the differentiation of 3x will be what? Will be 3 minus 0, because 1 is constant and the differentiation of constant is 0. So we write 3x minus 1 whole square. This implies, now we write minus 2 x plus 1 whole square minus 3x minus 1. Now multiply this 3 n x to the power n, because minus 1 plus 1 will be cancelled, so if we get 3 n x to the power n minus n x to the power n minus 1 minus 3x square divided by 3x minus 1 whole square. Okay. Now we again solve it. Sorry, here is a mistake. Here is x square. So it will be x square and here will be 2x, and further we write here what, multiply this 6x square minus 2x minus 3x square by 3x minus whole square. We get minus 2 by x plus 1 whole square minus 6x square minus 3x square 3x square minus 2x by 3x minus 1 whole square. Okay. Now it will be our answer. Let's see what we have done. We have given two functions, this and this. So here we write x to the power minus 1, minus 1, x to the power minus 2, and here apply the quotient rule. We get d differentiation of n minus n differentiation of d upon d square, and this will be differentiation 2x, and here we get 3. Multiply this, okay, and multiply this term inside, here inside, we get this. After subtracting, we get the result. Okay. Now, the next question we will see in the next class.